Hey now, Rodney Erdickson here, and this is my first impression overview of the co-op mode in Alien Breed 2. For those of you who have played Alien Breed Impact, which was the first in the series, the game is very much the same, in the sense that in the co-op mode, you have very little storyline, you have hesitate to use the term skirmish, you have a survival mode, horde mode, whereby you are partaking in waves and waves of enemies in defending yourself. As with the first game, your ammo access is scarce. Of course, you always have your pistol, which is unlimited. As you could see, the atmosphere upon these space stations, or whatever you're on, I don't know, there's not much storyline to this, is meant to be rather spooky, rather scary, rather surprising. Everything's illuminated by your different flashlight or torch paths. You have a map indicating your waypoint that you're supposed to go to. The view, the camera view, doesn't rotate. It's stuck in overhead isometric. You have, obviously, a laser pointing the direction in which you're shooting, the benefit of which, of course, you also have a targeting reticule that only appears for your player and not your co-op player, which helps in differentiating between who is who. Essentially, control of your player character is handled through WSAD, unless you remap, and the mouse is used for firing. As you can see, I'm now out of my primary weapon, which was a machine gun. Now all I have at my disposal is the handgun. The handgun is has unlimited ammo, but unfortunately its fire rate is slow and it does rather little damage. What you also have is you have melee attacks, but they themselves are certainly not powerful. This is not a Call of Duty game where a melee attack will down an enemy instantly, and therefore the game proposes quite a challenge. Now, as it stands, it should be noted that the game does have push-to-talk functionality, so you could communicate with your co-op partner. You also have the ability to search human corpses, to pick up various ammunition, various weapons. There are terminals in which you could use some of that hard-earned money that you collect in order to buy generally more ammo. Essentially, the way game progression works, as you could see right now, my health is flashing dangerous. I'm going to use a health kit. There we go. Provided next to nothing, I have no more... whoopsie. I have no more items. Oh, yes, I do. I have another health kit. Here we go. Large health kit. There we go. The way progression works is both of you essentially gun your way to the checkpoints. Your goal, of course, is to survive. Should one of you perish, should the other player stay alive, the goal is that your countdown meter, your revival timer, if you will. As you can see, my buddy's down here. He has... oh, I'm being raided. Oh no, it's over. If I had respawned... if he had respawned in time while I was still alive, we would have continued our gameplay. However, that wasn't the case, as the game is very hard. Well, there you go. I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps.